Okay, so let's take a look first what is the complete offering from STM32 and its ecosystem for graphical user interfaces. Before we go into details, let me say a few words about the evolution in human-machine interfaces. Since the first machines, there was a need to have an interactivity between the human and the machine. And of course, the first ones were very simple ones with mechanical push buttons, electromagnetic gauges, and very simple displays. This has been evolving during the past few decades from these simple controls to more advanced controls up to today. And of course, the evolution was pretty much accelerated by the arrival of mobile devices such as mobile phones and tablets. And we see across the different markets that today end customer expectation is really referring to mobile phones, and they expect that their coffee machine, washing machine, home thermostat, alarm system, keypad, and many other applications will interact with them in a similar way. In order to implement this, of course, there are different ways, different needs, and let's take a look how this can be done with STM32. And of course, I cannot forget to mention one very nice example of such evolution in user interfaces, and this is the recently happened one, so with the successful launch of the first Dragon spaceship from SpaceX program. Here on this picture, maybe you have seen it on, it has been circulating on many social medias, but here we have the very nice example of evolution starting from the Apollo program, then the shuttles, and finally the Dragon. So this really show the big evolution and the big change of the user interface between the human and the machine. I'm sure all of you are not developing the user interface of a spaceship, but today if I look on my coffee machine in my home, I have a feeling it's a kind of small spaceship as well. Okay, so what's really needed when developing a graphical user interface with general purpose microcontroller like STM32 is. First of all, you need the hardware itself. So you need a device which will be capable to make all the graphical implementation. And here it strongly depends on which user interface you are really designing. If it will be some simple user interface, you may go with a simple STM32 where the display is connected over SPI. And here you don't need really big stuff. On the other side, if you want to connect already a few inch, 4-7 inch size of display with, let's say, reasonable color depth and nice graphical animations, for this you already need a little bit more powerful STM32, and I'm sure you will benefit in your application as well with dedicated graphical accelerators that can help to offload CPU from all the graphical operations. And inside STM32, you find part numbers with which can answer all these needs. So once you pick the right STM32, the next important point, of course, is to have the right tools and the right libraries and framework in order to implement the final user interface in a very simple and smooth way. And this is something that we bring today with all the STM32 Cube ecosystem plus the TouchGFX libraries that are now part of it. Next point, which is very useful whenever you are starting a user interface application, it is to have a kind of reference design which can help you to make the first mock-up, the first evaluation of the solution before you decide to go on with the further development. And then once the development is started on your site, nothing and nobody's at the end perfect, so as we. And I'm sure you will face some questions. So it's important to get supported with the right timing in order to make your design really moving on without further delays. And finally, we know that having all the tools, all the libraries coming from ST, that may not be the best solution at a given time for you. So we try to keep extended ecosystem of partners that have their own a bit different solutions addressing graphic user interfaces, and this is something that I will show you also at the end of this presentation, so you know what are all the other options. And here we have the complete portfolio of STM32 family today, where you see all the main series, from the simple ones like F0, G0 or L0, up to the most advanced one like F7, H7 and even the microprocessor line, which is the STM32 MP1. The important point is that today you have really 18 different lines, 18 different series. You get more than 1,200 different part numbers based on different technologies with a different memory footprints, different set of peripheries, and different support also for graphical user interface implementation. And this gives you a huge flexibility in selecting and deciding for the best fitting STM32, bringing you the most optimized set of technical features for the right price. And at the end, as many of you are designing applications that are addressing industrial markets fair, very important is the longevity commitment. And here we keep our 10 years longevity commitment, which is rolling over and over year by year. So currently you have it granted from January 2020 for the next 10 years. Now let's have a look on the STM32 devices that are suitable for more advanced graphical user interfaces. And here we have again a big variety of different types, starting from the bottom with the STM32 L4 Plus, which is based on our ultra low power technology and offers a great ratio between technical capabilities, power consumption, and including the support of driving the displays and specific accelerator like Chrome GRC optimizing the RAM usage for rounded displays. Then within the F4, F7 and H7 families, of course you have a variety of a power, of internal flash, internal RAM, the different display controller interfaces and the other accelerators. But as you can see, all of them includes the Chrome art, which can very nicely offload the CPU from graphical operations. And you can find, and you will see later on in the other chapters, how nicely it can reduce the CPU load from up to 70% down to 4% of a load, which means you get a lot of free CPU resources for the rest of your application, which is great. And then on the top, the specific microprocessor line, which has a dedicated graphical core. And of course, this is the one where apparently you will run Linux or Android operating system of your application. Here I would like to underline two series that could be used very nicely for graphical user interfaces and are a bit specific or new. So the specific one is the F7 and H7 value lines that are bringing very nice ratio of technical features and an attractive price. This is achieved thanks to the relatively small embedded flash, which goes up to 128 kilobytes of flash, giving you a kind of possibility of having a boot, very quick boot, and the boot or the most sensitive code integrated inside the microcontroller. And the rest, for the rest of the program, you need to use external flash. These devices are in full production, are available in variety of different packages, and are featuring all the necessary accelerators for implementing graphics. On the right side, we have one of the latest STM32 H7 sublines, and this is the H7A or H7B line, which is also in production. And the nice feature of this one is that it has one of the biggest SRAM up to now inside STM32, and it goes up to 1.4 megabyte. And with this embedded SRAM, you can achieve to implement up to two buffers, frame buffers for your graphical operations to be integrated and supported up to half VGA and 16 bits per pixel graphical color depth without the need of external RAM. So this is a great feature allowing you to save on the BOM cost, optimize your design, make your PCB more simpler and more robust. And of course this one as well is coming in different type of packages and features all the advanced graphical accelerators. So I recommend you to look at those lines whenever you are trying to find the right device for a bit more advanced graphical user interfaces. Okay, so moving from the hardware part of the story to the tools and software, firmware, the STM32 offer coming from ST is based on the TouchGFX technology. Combining STM32 microcontroller graphical features with this TouchGFX technology, we enable you to develop the maximum user interface performance on STM32 microcontrollers. And this beating any competing microcontrollers or even beating low-end microprocessors. TouchGFX software structure keeps the developer in control, making him fully capable of replicating the look and feel created by the graphical art and design people, which is very important. TouchGFX includes TouchGFX Designer, which is a drag-and-drop programming tool that enables you to create very easily complete prototypes. And it includes a simulator, so you can see the implementation immediately on your PC without the need of target hardware platform. Then the TouchGFX is divided into additional pieces of a software. So the designer tool, which as I said is a PC program where you can create all the visual appearances of your user interface, and then the TouchGFX engine itself, which is the software library handling in the optimized way all the rendering that is running on a real target. The main news within the STM32 ecosystem related to graphics back in first quarter of 2020 was the introduction of the X-Cube-TouchGFX. The X-Cube-TouchGFX is a software expansion package that brings on top of the already mentioned TouchGFX designer and the TouchGFX engine, so-called TouchGFX generator. The TouchGFX generator is a STM32 CubeMX plugin which provides a configuration of your hardware and software for the graphical part of your project. So it brings and makes the link between the TouchGFX itself and the STM32 CubeMX as a tool that you can use in your application to configure all the rest, all the remaining application blocks, whatever it could be, from basic LED or push button configuration of your GPIO ports, or up to extensive communication interfaces such as USB or Ethernet. So with this X-Cube-TouchGFX package, we have solved the interoperability points, bringing all together and making sure that with the CubeMX or with the IDE of your choice and with this X-Cube-TouchGFX, you can make your development as smooth as possible. While you get all further details around TouchGFX and the X-Cube-TouchGFX expansion package in the next chapters of this MOOC series, let me continue with the presentation of the additional blocks and additional offering related to graphics. And these are the reference designs. So from STM32 family, typically for each series you get a set of boards from the simple nuclear boards up to the evaluation boards, including the discovery kits. And for all the lines, STM32 lines that are featured with support for graphical user interfaces, you will find typically one discovery kit which contains a different type of display connected with a different type of display interfaces, whatever it could be, parallel RGB or MIPI DSI interface, and it typically features also different type of external memories. So with these discovery kits, which are relatively affordable, typically not exceeding $100, you can get a hardware platform that you can use right away to make a first quick mockups or evaluation how your graphical user interface could look like using STM32 and the selected graphical framework. Typically, there are nice demo examples included inside the STM32 Cube HAL libraries coming mostly in the source code that you can reuse, or you can use them as a kind of starting point or get inspired by them as well. Another alternative of such a reference design could be the bigger evaluation board. There are not so many as we have with Discovery Kits. They are a bit more costly as well, but on the other side they are offering a bit more richer set of features and connectivity options on the board itself. So if you are looking for a board with a bigger display, with even higher set of connectivity and external ICs around the STM32, please don't forget to check the evaluation boards of STM32. When talking about STM32 reference designs for graphics, I have to mention the new application templates, which are now embedded inside the TouchGFX Designer. These application templates are really a great starting point for your evaluation and further steps in development of your own graphical user interface when doing it with our STM32 boards. Moving on with the STM32 offer presentation, we have reached the point of the support. Support is very important at every design, and for graphics it's valid as well. So today you can find a lot of digital content, including videos, libraries, documentation available around TouchGFX, around STM32. There is a very nice community forum dedicated to TouchGFX, knowledge base which you can use. And with all this information, I'm sure this will help you to move on with your design using TouchGFX and STM32 relatively quickly. Mentioning the support and the documentation, I cannot miss the introduction of a new documentation website that has been introduced during Q2 of 2020. You can see the link, and this new webpage is really centered around the TouchGFX Designer, TouchGFX Generator, and the TouchGFX framework itself. It provides better overview. It has a specific focus on the process of building a TouchGFX application from start to finish. All the STM32 graphics features are explicitly handled, and we will be keep enriching this documentation day by day with new content. Closing up around the support, a special highlight should be taken around the TouchGFX community. This community is very rich in terms of content. There are a lot of answers to, let's say, daily questions or specific questions from designers already working with STM32 and TouchGFX. The community is directly moderated by ST engineers, including people that are behind the TouchGFX graphical framework. So I recommend everyone to use it for the first questions that they may have or issues that they may face when developing with STM32 and TouchGFX. Well, last part of the STM32 offer is dedicated to extended graphical ecosystem. We know that there is not only TouchGFX as a solution addressing graphical user interfaces. There are many other solutions coming from different partners, and at the end the selection of the best one fitting your needs is on you. What is important for us is that all those partners are making their solution adapted in the best way to STM32, benefiting from its features. So we stay in very close contact with them, helping them to make sure that their solutions are following the latest trends and the latest news from STM32 family as well. And here we are closing the STM32 offer with a list of TouchGFX implementers. These companies, these partners, are masterizing the use of STM32. They are masterizing the use of TouchGFX, and they could be of great help when you are designing your own graphical interface and you are short of resources or of a know-how, and you need very quickly to come on the market with a nice, modern and featured user interface. So don't hesitate to get in touch with them, and if needed, we can make the bridge to them as well. So you can contact your ST representative and we'll be very happy to bridge you to them. So we have reached the end of this presentation. Thanks a lot for your attention. And let me just underline that whenever you are in front of starting a design of graphical user interface of your embedded application with STM32 and its ecosystem, you won't make a wrong choice. And so I'm very happy to invite you to follow the next chapters of this MOOC series, going into the details of TouchGFX, going into the details of STM32 support for graphics or the accelerators, follow up with the brilliant hands-ons where in practical ways we will try to show you how to go step by step from starting simple UI up to more advanced implementations and interaction with the rest of the application. So thanks again and all the best to you.